Reels is definitely a stage, right? It's literally a stage where you come in and you know your talent is there for the whole world to see, and you don't need 100 cameras and a crew to be able to showcase that, right?
I know the designs are new and this looks like some other show, but no, it's same. It's Pepper Spotlight itself. Hello everyone, welcome to the 24th episode of our show. My name is Pawan Rochwani. I think we have established that in the last 23 weeks. And in this week's episode, we are going to talk about something that has taken over the internet last 1 year entirely. Reels. And we're going to talk directly to somebody from Instagram, Roxanne, who looks after this segment entirely at the platform. We're going to speak to her about what has happened on the platform with respect to Reels, how it has almost changed every creator, and how few creators have also gone viral over the platform, and what are some other things that Instagram is going to do in the coming years. But before we get into the whole conversation, please let us know if you like this new layout of the design that we're putting it now, and if you have any suggestions or recommendations as to whom we should invite on the show, please just feel free to put it in the comment section or just DM us on Instagram. And without taking any much time, let's get into this conversation. This was pre-recorded with Roxanne, so we're going to listen to our conversation, which was pre-recorded also, all from her onwards.
Thank you so much, Roxanne, for being on Pepper Spotlight. I think I'm so thrilled and excited to have this conversation with you. To give you a little backstory, I think when we were doing this contest / campaign called Next Big Creators at the start of this year, we were trying to reach out to some folks from Instagram and Facebook to, partner with us and, help us in that. We couldn't do that at that point of time, but so happy that today we are doing this conversation when it's also 1 year to Reels in India. So thank you so much for giving us your time today.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm so excited to be here. I can't believe it's been a year of Reels, and I'm so excited to talk about it today in more detail. But I think over the past 1 year, the kind of year that Reels has had and the way that, creators and communities have shown up for it, just the creativity, the passion, the authenticity, the sheer range of creation and expression that we've seen has just blown us away. The way that we see Reels being adopted, across India in smaller towns, and, regional trends being kickstarted as well. So excited to share more, and, so excited for what lies ahead.
Yeah. I came onto Instagram a little late. This is 2016 or 17. By this point of time, all my friends in college were already on the platform. They were so excited and happy to be sharing photos and all of those things. And I used to be like, do I want to, put so many photos and all of those things? But once I got onto the platform in 2016 or somewhere early 2017, I realized, oh, wow, this is really cool. And from there onwards, I also started building a community of different creators and all of those things. And I cannot believe that this is such a great platform, and it's completely free for you to connect with so many individuals, build maybe your own brand, your organization, literally everything via content. But I would want to know from you, what are some, recent changes or updates or trends that we have seen on the platform? Like Reels was something that came last year, but what were some other major changes? I think I also remember earlier you could only put 15 seconds video, then it got it to 60 seconds, and then IGTV was there, and some other updates like you can also share your IG live directly to IGTV and some of these things, which were really, really helpful for people to create diverse kind of content. But I would want to know from you, what were some of the trends that happened in the last few years on Instagram?
So I think so much has happened, which is the most exciting thing. And currently though, Reels is still 30 seconds. You can still just do 30 seconds. So, but I think two things that come in mind, and Pawan, I love, the start of your question. That's exactly what Instagram stands for at the heart of it. Like the mission of Instagram really is bringing you closer to the people and things you love. And I'm so glad to hear that, you know, that's been the journey for you, right? That's truly what we want, you know, connecting people to, you know, what they love, what they like, whether it's creators, communities, you know, all of those things. I think two things that definitely come to mind, you know, when we see, you know, the evolution of this journey is video and short form video. I think video, India is such a video first market, right? And 70 to 80% of, you know, all data here, right, is video led. So video is a massive priority for us. And our video services across, you know, the family of apps are our Facebook, our Facebook Watch, there's IGTV, and of course there's Reels, right? I think the second really exciting thing is short form video, right? Super, super important part of our strategy and, you know, how we see things play out. I think one of the most exciting parts about short form video, especially in the context of Reels, is just this whole democratization of creativity. That's a very, very long word. But I think it's just been so exciting to see that happen, where, you know, the athlete is more important than the team. You don't have to rely on a music label to go bonkers viral and put your music out there, right? You don't need to rely on an art gallery to be able to display your, you know, your art, or, you know, those kinds of things, right? And I think it's truly sort of reflected in how we see people use Instagram all over India, right? And, you know, the way that is sort of starting to play out. So I think it's been really, really exciting, and we can't wait to see where this whole, you know, pulse with short form video will lead us.
Yeah. And I think that democratization is also leading to more independent artists being confident about, you know, their art, people starting their own brands on the platform, start being an entrepreneur. So today creators are not just, let's say, artists / creator, they're also being entrepreneurs. So I think that has also happened.
I couldn't agree more. In fact, I think one of, you know, you mentioned artists, and I definitely want to talk about our independent artist program that we've recently launched across Facebook and Instagram. And there the idea is that anybody, you know, who is making their own music can now have that music distributed on our Facebook and Instagram library, right? So we recently launched it a month back. But I think that's just one example of the way that we're sort of adding to this, you know, shift where anybody can come in and, you know, harness the power of this platform and, you know, build their own story and community.
Yeah. And I think that's really shaping the kind of content also that is there on the platform, and also the diversity in terms of products or, you know, art that is being created. So I think that's really, really cool. And, you know, something that I really enjoy on the platform currently. Moving on from that, I think, you know, I am such a nerd and geek about social media in general. I have Google alerts about Instagram, Facebook, literally anything. You name it, I have a Google alert for it on a daily basis. I keep seeing what's happening across the world. And I've seen recently how, when it was like the Creator Week, I think in the month of June or a few weeks back, how a lot of series of blogs, what the algorithm is about, how Instagram works, and, you know, multiple other things. How can you get better at Reels? And some of the tips that I think you also shared on your profile, that have a good video and some things like those kind of things while you're shooting Reels. And I read all of those stuff, and I talk about it to all the people who are connected to me, so they can be helped about how to get better at creating content. But what is like one thing, if you have to choose, like, okay, only one thing which can help people to absolutely kill it on Instagram? IG Live, or what is that one thing?
So I'm actually going to take like the liberty to sort of talk about two attributes with content.
Okay. You're the guest on the show, so you can take two or three.
Amazing. So I think the first one definitely is authenticity. I feel like just the way that Instagram is built, right? It is built for expression and entertainment, right? And if you just see the way that, you know, content creators have built their journey here, I think the more authentic you are, the more, you know, the more power you give to your personal voice, I think that truly makes you stand out, right? And it truly gives you I think gives other people a reason to follow you and sort of be invested in you and your journey, right? And I think if you see any upcoming creator, any large creator on the platform, right, they truly have a signature, right, that makes them stand out and, you know, makes people want to sort of get in on them on the long haul, right? So I think authenticity is super, super important. What is it about you that is different? Where, for example, you're not creating the 5,000th version of the same video, but the first of, you know, of your unique, you know, sort of take or trend or, you know, your unique sort of standpoint on something, right? I think that is really, really important. The second is consistency. We truly believe that, I think in anything, right? This is a journey and it's a marathon and not a sprint, right? And as you're really building this connection with your community, you must show up for them consistently in the form of your content, right? I think being consistent also ensures that you're experimenting, you develop your own content niche. I think Sakshi Sandhwani, for example, I love the fact that, you know, she started a 365-day series where every day she uploaded a video on the platform, right? Mad consistency.
Yeah.
And the kind of journey she had post that, right? The kind of sort of habitual viewing that she built with her audience. I think that was phenomenal to see. So it truly is about consistency, right? And for anybody sort of thinking about, you know, making content, you know, showing up on the platform, super, super important to make sure that you have a strategy that is built around consistency. So pick a niche, you know, build around it, keep building and, you know, keep showing up and things will happen.
Yeah, I think I'm just going to make this like a quote or make a t-shirt out of this, that this journey is not a sprint, it's a marathon. Be consistent, keep building it every day.
It so is. And, you know, look at the things that we're building on Reels as well, right? We're adding new features so quickly and consistently. And I think that's one of the coolest parts about content creation, right? The amount of, you know, new things it throws at you and the change that it throws at you. And I think change truly is the only constant here, right? And it truly is about picking that up and evolving with it. And I think consistency and authenticity goes a long way, right? In making sure that you harness that well.
Yeah. I'm also happy that I'm going to bring up a t-shirt. I'll pay you royalty for that. Moving on, you know, it's something that I want to ask you and, you know, want to majorly cover about in this conversation today is about Reels. It's been 1 year and it has took off massively. People who were hesitant to showing their faces, especially like writers, I know a lot of writers and, you know, they used to just post content and, you know, on their feed with just text and all of those things, they have started to create Reels. People have become more friendly on coming IG live and things like that. So it's not just about they are now willing to create more Reels, but it has made creators more confident about being on the camera and things like that. But what was it about Reels that you think connected so well in India? And literally everyone is creating Reels today. Trust me, everyone that I follow, all of them are creating Reels. I follow like 2,000 people from my personal account and almost like 90% of them might be creating Reels.
What did it resonate
so well with the creators and the audience in India?
I think definitely, like I said, you know, India definitely is a video first market, right? And short form video is seeing such massive consumer interest, right? And so we introduced Reels, you know, looking at that moment and hearing our community. And we wanted to make sure that short form video in the context of Instagram and Reels is a very unique experience for anybody on the platform, right? I think while Reels is all about entertainment, we're seeing people use Reels in such amazing ways to further their journey on the platform, right? I think the first, of course, is using Reels to grow and be discovered, right? I think just the way that the product is built and the massive consumption it's seeing, it's a great way for you to, you know, to grow, to get a whole different audience, you know, sort of getting people from all over the world. Instagram is not geo-gated, right? So you could literally, you know, have access to completely, you know, crazy and, you know, beautiful, you know, audience, you know, wherever you want to sort of build that, right? I think the second, of course, is I think people are using Reels so beautifully to to engage with this community, right? I think people have realized that this is a truly global community. Yeah. And, you know, the way that they're creating content and, you know, tailoring it and sort of, you know, evolving and, you know, sort of growing and ebbing with trends, I think that's been super, super exciting to see. The kind of collabs that we've seen, especially even with Remix, right? We've seen creators from India and all over the world collaborate on Remix and, you know, reshare each other's content. And it's been super exciting to see. I think a couple more are, of course, the whole, I think, harnessing the power of music and original audio, right? I think that's just been phenomenal, whether it is creating your own spin on content or using music really creatively to spark a trend. I think we've seen that especially sort of take off and happen. In fact, one of our most popular hashtags is hashtag Sidhu Moosewala, right? And we've seen so many trends that have, say, combined an AR filter, you know, the recent, for example, you know, Barish Ki Jai, for example, right? Like combining that with an AR filter, even, for example, a song like Lut Gaye, right? Has so many reels on it. So I think even the whole homegrown, you know, the way that it's given rise to an entirely new crop of music creators, right? Whether it's Fizza or anybody else, I think that's been really, really exciting to see. And I think lastly, which is, it's just been, and I think that keeps growing every day, and we're so blown away by this, especially this phenomenon, is people from smaller cities, you know, all around India, right, come in and use reels in their own way and spark trends in that sort of space, right? So yeah. I mean, prime example is Bajira Sitta, for example, right? Phenomenal to see. I think it's been so fun. In fact, a couple of our most sort of used hashtags are Marathi Mulgi and Kerala Gram, right? I think it just sort of shows the diversity of what people are doing on Reels, right? Yeah. We've also so been heartened by regional creators, you know, creating these amazing pan-India trends, right? Like, I think Oyang is such a great example, you know?
Yeah.
Like, Bole Chudia is one of our most, you know, popular tracks on Reels, and it's because of, you know, the remix that he created, right? I think another example is Surumi. She's a creator from Jalna, and I think her blues, like, cap has become a thing on Reels now, right? And the way that she sort of creates content. So I think there's so many examples like that, but I think a couple of these reasons are definitely why I think we're just seeing Reels literally like a rocket ship.
Though. Yeah. And I think this also makes it, makes everyone feel that, you know, they can also do it. Like, it doesn't matter if you're from Bombay, you're from Delhi, Bangalore, whatever, or if you have like the best of iPhones or the gears, but it's really about how you can just, you know, have an idea, shoot it in a reel and then just upload it and maybe it will go anywhere.
I couldn't agree more. I love the fact that Reels is definitely a stage, right? It's literally a stage where you come in and, you know, your talent is there for the whole world to see, and you don't need 100 cameras and a crew, you know, to be able to showcase that, right? I think especially, you know, even with, say, the entire, you know, comedy space that we've seen on Reels in the past year, right? Like creators like My Life, My Rules or Dushyant Kukreja, right? Like, I think they started off with, you know, literally phone, you know, simple phone sketches, right? That were made on the phone, and, you know, it's completely blown up. Right. So I think you need the power of an idea on Reels. You need a phone to do it. And, you know, you're on your way.
Yeah. And I think, you know, it's really, really very relatable also and very connecting. And it's just in 15 seconds or 30 seconds. So I think it's that consumption time also that really just makes it very cool to just engage with. You know, something else that I wanted to ask you was, how, you know, we have noticed some of these trends, let's say the runway filter that was there, or a particular track, it will go, you know, let's say really, really used by a lot of creators. One thing that I noticed, and, you know, these are just two different perspectives, and I would want to know your opinion about it, is, so if something goes trending, I see a lot of repetitive content about it. Like, everybody, no matter if that trend might be suitable for their content style, their brand or not, they might just, you know, loop into it and use that song or the filter or any of these things. What is your opinion about this? When something goes trending, is it helping other creators, or it's just going to make a lot of repetitive content for like somebody like me who's just like there to consume the content?
It's a super interesting question. I think entertainment is one of the core tenets of Reels, right? And we're definitely sort of leaning into that. I think with trends, I think what happens is they form almost like a stage, right? For someone to come in and showcase themselves and, you know, their talent, right? And I think trends are definitely a vehicle to sort of inspire and kickstart, you know, that phenomenon, right? I think one of the coolest things about trends, right, is that it provides a trigger, right, for content creation, right? It's literally a starting point for the possibility of what can come in future, right? But I think the true power of trends on the platform, and we see creators doing this so well, is really making the trend your own, right? I think really Reels is about your response to an entertaining or trending moment on the platform. It's about how you pick it up and put your own unique sort of, you know, spin or perspective or view or reaction on it, right? I think that's what helps you truly stand out, right? So I think what also happens with trends, right? Like you were saying, the absolute relatability of it, right? You look at it and you instantly go like, oh my God, hard relate, it me. Like, I can either make this or, oh my God, I want to join in on this, right? That's what it inspires. And that's why it's so fun to sort of look at it and you either want to literally jump up and, you know, literally mimic the same dance and upload that, or, you know, when you look at, say, even a comedy trend, right? You're like, oh my God, this creator gets me, right? Which is super, super exciting to see. I think with trends, right, I also don't think it means that originality is being suppressed. One of the most amazing things we've seen about trends is that when creators pick it up, right, they evolve the trend and give it direction in their own sort of way and right? We've seen a trend start with something and then keep evolving into something completely different, right? A trend could start in the comedy space but go into the dance space, right? A trend could start in the fashion and beauty space but go into the, you know, into the music space, for example, right? So I think that's been really, really cool to see. And finally, because trends are such a great indicator, right, of the flow and pulse of conversation on the platform, it's also helped you know, young upcoming homegrown creators get massive discoverability, right? Because of the unique spin that they've put in, right? Like I think a great example is Anumita Nadesan. So she had a cover on Jashne Bahara. I think it got millions of views. It was so great to see, right? But her spin on it is what truly caused her to stand out, right? And I think over 50,000 people created content using her original audio, right? And I think that's a great example of how you use a trend, right? Make it your own, you know, fuel something within the community that you have, and make a pulse of conversation, you know, especially about you and your take on what is happening.
That's really, really great. And I was just thinking about so many different examples, like I have seen on a particular trend or a music itself, there are dance videos, painting videos, cooking videos, travel videos, literally everything. Somebody is reading a book about it, somebody is mentioning a movie or any of those kind of things. So it's literally like, even if something is going trending, you see all kinds of content about it. You know, my next question was going to be, tell me some best practices about what to do for Reels. But let me put it in an interesting way. Let's say in the next 30 seconds, if you can tell any 3, 4, 5 best practices that creators should adapt to. And I'll literally just, let's make sure that
literally
we do it in 30 seconds.
Okay.
Yeah, so that we actually make this Reels about a reel later.
Pressure. Okay.
Let's say, what are any best practices for reels that creators should create? And you start 1, 2, 3 now.
Okay. First of all, consistency. Please publish on a schedule and think about it. Make sure you show up and you have a regular cadence. The second is collaboration. use Remix collaboration is great. The third is really, really engage with your community and get feedback on what you should make. The fourth is make trends your own, genuinely. You don't have to dance to everything. You don't have to be almost like a trend victim. Truly make a trend your own, right? And finally, experiment. Reels is an amazing playground for you to just try out new things. So don't forget to sort of experiment. And yeah, finally, one little production tip is thumbnails. Make sure your thumbnail is super sort of representative of what your content is and has text on it.
Super. We exited about 30, but that's okay. We'll make it in two parts.
Okay.
You know, and now moving on from Reels, and you know, something I want to know, what is coming up next on Instagram as a platform, or what are some next things that creators should look out for? I think, as I was telling you, I constantly keep checking what's happening on all of the Instagram pages, let's say the creators page, Instagram for business, and the main Instagram page also. So I think when recently Adam was on a live session, he also mentioned something like Instagram today is no more like a photo sharing app, how it was like back then. So what are some new things that are coming for creators that they should keep a lookout for, or let's say for brands also?
I think when we think about Instagram and Facebook, right, we definitely wanted to almost serve as a home base, right, for creators to tell their stories, to build a community, and of course, make a living, right? And I think we've made some important sort of points of progress there. There are a couple of things that we're definitely sort of looking forward to and currently, you know, testing in the US. The first, of course, is a native affiliate tool that's going to basically allow creators to discover new products that are available on checkout, share them with their followers, and earn commissions essentially for the purchase that they drive, right? All within the Instagram app, right?
Yeah.
I think the other crucial thing for creators, of course, is merchandise. I think that's super, super important to like their journey. And, you know, most creators are really, really excited about the prospect of making sure that they're able to sell and create merch and sort of make that available, for the people who follow them, right? So we're basically making it easier for them to add an existing shop or open up a new shop on their Instagram profile, right? This is still in the US, but we're very, very excited about the prospect of it, you know, coming here in the future. And of course, we will share more when there's an update. We're very excited to see how these developments pan out.
Super. And you know, one last question, and I think this is something that a lot of creators wanted to know, when is actually this going to happen, which is about, you know, monetization opportunities on the platform. Let that be via the shop feature or the affiliate feature, or I think a lot of, I think this was, let's say, a rumor, or this was spread out that monetization is going to come to IGTV, how, let's say, it's on YouTube, or I think Facebook already gives monetization capabilities for the videos via your page. But on Instagram, what are some monetization capabilities that might come, even if they are not, like, let's say, in pipeline?
So like I said, I think we're definitely looking for ways to accelerate, you know, ways for creators to make a living and for small businesses as well. So like I said, you know, we're testing affiliate, we're testing, you know, the ability to sell your own merchandise. There is a lot happening in this space, and we will definitely have updates to share in the future for sure. So unfortunately, we don't have a locked in date yet, but when there's an update, Pavan will be the first person to sort of make, you'll know.
Super. I'll spread it across everywhere once that date and announcement is
made. You can make a reel about it.
Super. Thank you so much, Bud, for this conversation. I think, you know, something that has, you know, stayed in right now, even when I'm thinking about how to conclude this conversation, I think for every creator, they should just know that this journey is not like a sprint. It's a marathon. You have to be consistent, no matter if you're doing reels or stories or on the feed. You have to be consistent.
I couldn't agree more. I think to anybody listening, I would say enjoy the process, right? I think content creation is such an exciting, amazing, living, breathing thing, right? Yeah. And, you know, the power of the community that you can build on Instagram through your content, right? And the, and you know, just the lives that you can touch and the voice that you can have is amazing. So definitely enjoy the process, keep at it, find your own voice and niche, especially on Reels, and you know, deep dive into it. And yeah, just it's been a year. I can't believe it's been a year since we launched Reels. Just want to say thank you to everybody who's been on the platform and, you know, has contributed to its phenomenal growth. I think we're just getting started with short form video in India and just so excited to see what's next.
You know, before we end it, I want to ask you some very small sub question kind. What are some unique creators that you follow and thoroughly enjoy consuming their content? Because I think I follow all, like, somebody goes viral, so from there onwards I follow them. But any let's say people who are like upcoming or aspiring creators that you think, oh, they are going to make it really big, that people should, you know, watch out for?
I'll definitely share a couple of names whose content I enjoy, and I think it's really different, standout-ish, and you know, just is just like something that I'm totally into. I think the first is a creator called Harshleen Junts. She makes gorgeous beauty tutorials and, you know, beauty looks. So definitely check her out. I think she did a reel on the Marvel challenge, which blew up, and just she's phenomenally talented. I think in another one is definitely, I love My Life, My Rules. I love Nirmal. I think his content is so funny and relatable, and you know, does so, so well. I think someone else definitely is Ankit, Oy Ankit. I always look forward to his mashups. I think his, you know, the way that he's cracked the remix format, right, and truly made it his own, I think is just amazing to see. So that's something that I truly, truly enjoy. I think I love Fiza Sharma, her, you know, just the, you know, the covers and the songs that she puts up, I think are really, really beautiful. And lastly, I love Tanya, Glitters by Tanya. Check her out. She does insane beauty transition reels. Like, they are works of art and very, very amazing to see. So definitely for anyone.
I'm going to go and check out all these. Ankit, I already follow and I know him. I thoroughly enjoy all his reels. But I'm going to check out the different ones. Thank you so much once again for being on this conversation. I cannot wait to share this to all our listeners and viewers. But once again, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you, Pawan. Thank you for having me. Absolute pleasure. And yeah, and for anyone listening and making content on the birthday, please don't forget to tag your reels with Happy Birthday Reels so that we can see them. And thank you. Thank you, Pawan, for having me.
I hope this conversation helped you how to nail Instagram Reels. If you still have any more questions, please just put your questions in the comment section or just DM us and we'll try our best to address those to you. But one thing I also want to share with you all is please go ahead, follow Roxanne on Instagram. I think she puts up the most wonderful IG stories. And it's hilarious. So many creators from across the globe, and I thoroughly, thoroughly enjoy it. You can just check out her Instagram link from the description of this episode. And if you have any questions, please feel free to send it our way. You can listen to Pepper Spotlight on any of these audio platforms, and even on YouTube, we're going to do some really, really cool stuff in the coming weeks. And if you want to know more, just go ahead, DM me or on the Pepper page, or just comment. If you're listening to this on Spotify, please hit that Spotify follow button, Apple Podcasts, wherever these small little things just help us to reach out to more and more listeners. And also, let's get to that Spotify chart someday. We'll talk more about it very, very soon. But till that time, take care and stay safe.